Hello everyone, welcome to our channel C. Patel Metallurgy. Guys, we have called Mr. Ved Prakash Rai. He is currently working in Hindalco to share his experience. So we would like to know from a metallurgist point of view, like what are the works he looks into that, right? So I just want to give a brief introduction about him, that he is a graduate of NIT Jamshedpur and he has joined Hindalco in 2015. So around 4 to 5 years, yes, sir, and he is still serving. So over to you, Mr. Ved Prakash. So can you say something about this?
Thank you, Subodh, for inviting me on this channel. I'm very happy that I'm here and I could share some experience. I could share my experience. So I'm working in Hindalco for last 5 years. After graduating from NIT Jamshedpur in 2015, this company came for placement. So through placement, I got job in Hindalco, and for last 5 years, I'm here. So in month of July, I joined, and I joined in Hindalco Renukoot. So initially when I joined here, did 3 months of training. This was an induction training, and after 3 months of training, we got 6 months of on-job training in a fabrication department. And after 6 months, I was placed in a reduction technical. So I am working in smelter as a process control engineer. Here we have to find out all the abnormalities and solution of all the abnormalities. As you know that in aluminium, 5 to 40% cost, that is, you know, we have to work on the energy reduction project in production of aluminium. We ensure the better processes. We try to find out the project and analyze the abnormalities which could decrease the specific energy consumption in the aluminium manufacturing. So okay. as an engineer, this is my major work here.
Okay, wait. You are working in smelter, okay. So now tell me, like, what were the procedures for selection in Hindalco? Like, was there any written test, then interview, like that? And how was the test?
Yeah, in 2015, there were three rounds. The first was a written test that was taken by MCAT. MCAT is a private organization, and it take exams for the placement of the student. So MCAT came and they took our written exam. In written exam, there were four sections. The first one was about English verbal ability. Then the second one was numerical ability, and third one was related to our technical, specifically from the metallurgy. They asked a question from the metallurgy, and fourth one was about the reasoning. Some questions from reasoning were there, and we have to solve this. So this was a 3 hour exam, and after this test, they shortlisted 10 students, and from these 10 students, they took interview. At that time, there were two interview. First one was about the technical interview, and the second one was HR interview. So this both was like a knockout round. If we could not perform better, then we could go out of the any of these. So the first round we have to clear the technical, and after the technical HR. So we have to clear HR round. And out of these 10 students, 3 students were selected, and they are working with me in Hindalco.
Okay. So since you are working in Hindalco Renukoot, so what are the operations which are over there? Like this is an aluminium plant. So we have heard that it is an integrated plant, right? So I think everything happens over there. So just can you give a brief on that?
Yeah, in Hindalco Renukoot, three major units are there. The first one is about the refinery. Alumina produced from the bauxite, and then this alumina go to smelter. This alumina is reduced to aluminium, pure aluminium, and then this pure molten aluminium go to fabrication. So in fabrication, fabricated products are produced like rolled product, extrusion product, and the casting. So this is the three major unit here present.
Okay. And like different grades of aluminium we have studied in our colleges, right? So yeah, I think many students who have joined our channel, so they also might be learning different types of aluminium. So like 1 series, 2 series, 3 series. So this series of aluminium alloys would have been manufacturing over there, right? So that must have been very
manufacturing. Yeah. Here many grades of aluminium are produced, but in smelter these things are like alloying are not done. This is done in fabrication, where according to the requirement of a customer, they produce a specific grade of metal, like one series alloy metal, or 2 series, 3 series. This all depend on the requirement of customer. But in smelter, there is no such type of series of metal we produce. We just try to focus production of aluminium, which is 99%. The pure of aluminium should be greater than 99.7%, and we call here this is the P1020 production of metal, that is P1020 grade. In P1020 means silicon is less than 0.1%, and iron is less than 0.2%, and aluminium quantity is greater than 99.7%.
Okay, so that is very pure aluminium that we get from smelter. Okay.
Yeah.
That is an electrolysis process. That is also called a
Hall-Heroult
process, right?
Yeah. Smelter is based on Hall-Heroult process. With alumina, that is Al2O3, and this alumina go to smelter, which is based on Hall-Heroult process. In Hall-Heroult process, this alumina Al2O3 is reduced to pure aluminium. In this, there are many raw materials. Like for the production of 1 ton of aluminium, it require approximately 1.930, or you could say 2 kg of alumina, and 0.419 ton of carbon, and 15 to 16 kg of aluminium fluoride, and 13,700 to 13,800 unit DC kWh of energy. So this is the major input that we have to give for the production of 1 ton of aluminium.
So that is very high energy, I guess, very energy intensive process, this one, right?
Yeah, this is 35 to 40% of cost are involved in only energy. So the major, as an engineer, if someone is working in, so reduce the requirement of energy per ton of aluminium production. So this is one of the major project for any engineers in any of the smelter present in the world.
Okay. Yes, Vedh Prakash. Yes. Okay. And for a new metallurgist, suppose he or she wants to join the aluminium industry. So, what are the things they can prepare themselves? Like other industries has also come up along with Hindalco, like JSW, I guess Jindal, and some more maybe. So, what are the options in fields of aluminium industry for an aspirant? job spirit.
Yeah. Here in India, we have three major players in aluminium. The first one is Aditya Birla Group, Hindalco. Then the second one is Vedanta. And third one is Nalco. So this is the three major players which are present in smelter. Other than this, there are many other players like JSW and some other plants. But these three are the main major player in this field. And I have seen many people are working in Gulf also, because in Gulf country like UAE, Saudi Arabia. So what is there? The energy cost is very low in this country. So because of the low energy cost, there are many smelters are present in countries. So there is scope in these countries also. Someone has done a lesson from the metallurgy background. So he could go in Gulf country and European countries. So these are the major scopes that we have in smelter. And there are many fabrication plants in the world. And even in the India, we have many fabrication plants. Like JSW produce extruded product, Hindalco produce rolled product, cast product, extruded product. Nalco also produce some amount of product, and Vedanta is also a major product. So in non-ferrous metallurgy, there are lots of scope, but we have to learn continuously and we have to improve ourselves every day.
Okay, so what are the places where suppose someone joins Hindalco, then what are the locations which he can get basically if he wants to work in India only? Because we know Hindalco has some operations worldwide also. So in this also tell like whether this company sends someone to work abroad like that. Is there anything like that? Or okay, so can you just
Here in India, Hindalco have many plants like Hindalco Renukoot, Hindalco Hirakund, Hindalco Mahan, Aditya, Taloja, Dahej. These all are the Hindalco plant which are present in India. In Mahan, Renukoot is an integrated plant. In Mahan, they have a smelter of 350 kilo ampere. In Aditya, they have a smelter. In Utkal, they have a refinery that is based on a BS process. In Taloja and in Mauda, we have fabrication plant, like they produce fabricated products, especially the thin foils that are used for the production, packaging of medicine, used for making cane body, used for making thin foils. So these are produced in Taloja and Mauda. And in Utkal and Muri, they produce only alumina, which is used in other smelters of Hindalco. So these are all are the major Hindalco plant in India, in which we could work. There are lots of opportunities in Hindalco. After getting few years of experience, there is a scheme called internal recruitment system. So through IRS, we could apply to all these plants according to our convenience, according to our interest. Like someone is interested in fabrication and he want to work in Maharashtra, so he could apply through the IRS and he could go to Maharashtra. He may work there. Someone want to move to Gujarat, he could move to Dahej. If someone interested in Orissa, they could move to Aditya. So these all are the options available which we could explore through. Apart from this, engineers also get opportunity to work in sales, marketing, procurement, finance department. So there are always, you know, lots of vacancies come for only for the employees who are working in Hindalco. So if we have an interest after few years of working, if we are interested in learning some financial skills, then we could go to a finance department. If we have interest in learning some marketing and procurement skills, then we could go to the sales and marketing department. So these all opportunities are always available here in Hindalco, and these all are present at the different location. Like if we want to work in marketing, then we will get placement in Bangalore and Mumbai. If we want to work in fabrication, then we will get placement in Renuku, Tetaloja, opportunities which are present in Hindalco in India.
Yeah, it is very nice. So Ved, according to you, what are the things metallurgists should take care while preparing for a job like maybe in your company or some other company, for like core company? So what are the things they should take care while doing their study? Like they also write GATE, you know. So what are the technical things and non-technical things which should be taken care of?
Yeah, I had experience during placement after my graduation in 2015 that most of the companies take written exam, and that is based on our verbal numerical ability. So to improve our verbal ability, we should focus on some syllabus of CAT. CAT has many similarity with this selection process, and for technical, we could focus on a GATE syllabus. Like we could solve a 10 year of previous year question. This will be enough for a technical section, and we could solve questions from syllabus of CAT for the verbal ability and numerical ability. And for reasoning, MCAT, I have seen that most questions are very easy, but we need to practice it. And I feel that CAT syllabus is very helpful in preparing most of the placement exam in college. And for the technical, we could solve 10 year of questions from the GATE previous year question.
Okay.
For interview, we need to be very good in our technical section. So we should follow our theory section thoroughly. Like in Hindalco, they will ask questions from non-ferrous metallurgy. Like they will ask you Beer's process. They will ask you how the roll process, about the red mud, about the anode effect, about the noise, about the grade of aluminium, about the purity of aluminium, about the raw material involved in the production of aluminium, about the problems of aluminium manufacturing. So we could focus on these technical concepts.
So
Ved,
I think it was good conversation with you, so that many students must have learned many things, and some doubts might have been both clear regarding the company Hindalco and the how to prepare for this, and in general also, and with respect to your company also Hindalco. So thank you Ved for coming to our channel. Okay, and so I want to really thank you.
Thank you, Subodh, for giving me opportunity to come here and share my experience. I would say that Hindalco is a good company, and there are lots of learning opportunity and growth opportunities are here. If someone want to join it, it's a good company for metallurgists and engineers. So I would say only this, and I will appreciate your effort that you are you are doing such type of work. You are calling all the experts and all the people from the different industry, and you are taking interview and sharing, try to connect student with the industry. So it's a really a great effort that you are doing. I will appreciate this.
Okay, thank you, Ved.